Yes. Now we'll discuss about the anatomy of the prostate gland. Prostate gland is a fibromuscular glandular structure. It is situated in the lesser pelvis. If you make a diagram, this is pubic bone. This is urobladder. This is urethra. And here is position of urogenital diaphragm. This is perineal body. This is urogenital diaphragm. Here is perineal body. This is membranous urethra. Here is position of this is rectum, this is anal canal, here is anal canal. And this is position of the prostate. This is position of the prostate. Here in posterior side, in posterior wall of this prostatic urethra, here is prostatic utricle. And another thing, here is a ejaculatory duct. So here is ejaculatory duct. And here is position of seminal vesicle. This is seminal vesicle. Ureter. So this is peritoneal covering. Here is peritoneal covering. Here a pouch is formed. This is a recto vesical pouch. And here is a recto vesical fascia of the Dinon veneer. Here is a recto vesical fascia of the, this is a recto vesical fascia of Dinon veneer is present. So this is vector vesical fascia of the Dinon veneer. And here is under fascia. Here lies loose connective tissue. And this is known as retropubic space. Retropubic space of retgius. This is retropubic space of retgius. And this is urogenital diaphragm. This is sagittal section. If you see in coronal section, you will find this is urobladder, and here is prostatic part of urethra. Here is position of urogenital diaphragm. This is urogenital diaphragm. This is urogenital diaphragm. Here lies membranous urethra. This is prostatic part of urethra. Here lies prostate. This is prostate gland. And lateral to this, here lies levator ani muscle. This is levator ani muscle. here this is neck of uribladder, here is urogenital diaphragm, and this is prostate. This part is prostatic urethra, and this prostatic urethra, if you see here, here a fold is present, fold of the mucosa, here forms the urethral crest. This is urethral crest, and on both sides of this urethral crest there is prostatic sinus. So this part is prostatic sinus. Prostatic sinus. In the prostatic sinus, there are numerous opening of the duct of the prostatic glands. So it has glandular part. So glandular part opens through these ducts into prostatic sinus. And here there is an elevation. This elevation here, in this elevation there is an opening. This elevation is known as Veru Mountain. It is also known as Seminal Colliculus. So Veru Mountainum or Seminal Colliculus, this is this opening on the posterior. You can see this and the posterior wall. This is prostatic utricle, and this prostatic utricle opens here in the Veru Mountainum. This opening is opening of the prostatic utricle. So this is opening of the prostatic utricle. In female, this prostatic utricle forms the uterus and cervix. This is analogous with uterus and cervix of the female. And lateral to this, there is another opening. Here is two ejaculatory ducts. So lateral to this, there is another opening. This is ejaculatory duct. So here you can see, these are the two another openings here, lateral to this. This is ejaculatory duct. So these are ejaculatory duct. And here is another elevation. Here is position of the ureter, this is trigone, and on posterior side here in this trigone area, there is slight elevation. This is known as jugula vesicae. This is jugula vesicae. This elevation is due to underlying median lobe. Here is position of median lobe. This is median lobe. Due to this median lobe, because this median lobe, small projection is present on posterior side. So this is median lobe. So if you see the shape of this prostate, it is like inverted cone. It is inverted cone like. It is like a chestnut like. It is like a chestnut or inverted cone in shape. It has apex, which is directed downward, and apex related with the urogenital diaphragm. It has base. Base is broad and related with the uri bladder and neck of the uri bladder. It has apex, base. It has four subsets. that this anterior surface, this anterior surface is dotted with the retropubic space of retigius. It has posterior surface. This posterior surface is dotted with the rectovesical fascia of Dillon Barrier. This is rectovesical fascia of Dillon Barrier. It has two inferolateral surface, right and left inferolateral surface, right and left inferolateral surface are related with the levator ani. Levator ani. So it has apex, it has base, and it has four surfaces: anterior surface, posterior surface, and two lateral surface, two inferolateral surface. So these are four surfaces, and you have seen the relation of the all four surfaces. And one important thing: this posterior surface is clinically important for the examination of the prostate. Perrectally, this posterior part is examined. From inner opening, its distance is about 4 cm. So perrectally it can be examined. In case of benign hypertrophy, when median lobe is enlarged, or in case of carcinoma prostate, where the posterior lobe is enlarged and irregular in shape, so this can be examined perrectally. So from anus to opening is anus opening to this level, length is about 4 cm. And posteriorly also related with the, there is seminal vesicle in upper part, and it is pierced by ejaculatory duct. So these are the structures related with the all surfaces, apex, base. And it's, if you see its dimension, it is 4 cm into 3 cm into 2 cm. And its weight is about 8 grams. This 4 cm is transverse dimension. This is maximum transverse dimension. This is transverse dimension. And this 3 cm is vertical, and 2 cm anterior posterior. So here you can see the transverse diameter is more than the vertical diameter. So this dimension is less in comparison to this. So transversely is more than the vertical dimension. Same example is present in the cecum. In cecum also the vertical dimension is less, this vertical dimension less in comparison to transverse dimension. So here you can see transverse 4 and vertical is 3, and its weight is 8 grams. Now you can see here the structures piercing this prostatic urethra. These are structures which piercing this prostatic urethra, you can see. And on medial side, medial plane, you have the crest. These are the perimentorium and the ejaculatory ducts, and here are the prostatic sinuses. So this is all about the prostate gland part 1.